C# includes a set of preprocessor directives that are mainly used for conditional compilation. Although the C# compiler does not have a separate preprocessor, as C and C++ compilers, the directives shown here are processed as if there was one. That is, they appear to be processed before the actual compilation takes place. The preprocessor directives are easily distinguished from normal programming code, in that they start with the hash sign. They must always occupy a line that is separate from anything else, except for single line comments. White space may optionally be included around the hash sign. The if and end if directives specify a section of code that will be included or excluded based on a given condition. Most often, this condition will be a conditional compilation symbol. Such a symbol is created using the define directive, followed by the symbol's name. When a symbol is defined, it will then cause a conditional expression using that condition to be evaluated as true. The symbol will remain defined only within the current source file, starting from the line where the symbol is created. The undefined directive can disable a previously defined symbol. Just as with the C# if statement, the if directive can optionally include any number of else if directives, and one final else directive. Conditional directives may also be nested within another conditional section. In longer conditionals, it is a good practice to add comments to the end if directives, to help keep track of which if directive they correspond to. There are two diagnostic directives, error and warning. The error directive is used to abort a compilation by generating a compile time error. This directive can optionally take a parameter that specifies the error description. Similar to error, the warning directive generates a compilation warning message. Unlike error, this directive will not stop the compilation. Another directive that affects the compiler's output is line. This directive is used to change the line number and optionally the source file name that is displayed when an error or warning occurs during compilation. This is mainly useful when using a program that combines the source files into an intermediate file which is then compiled. The last two directives are region and end region. They delimit a section of code that can be expanded or collapsed using the outlining feature of Visual Studio. Just as the conditional directives, regions can be nested any number of levels deep.